Here we're going to discuss what's called the phase shift for trig functions. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at the sine function in standard form. And that would be this. Y is equal to A multiplied by sine of B multiplied by X minus C plus D. So what I'd like you to do, I'd like you to write your trig functions with the argument like this. That is where if you have x multiplied by something, you factor that something out. So you end up with a factor, in this case b, multiplied by x plus or minus something. And the reason is because the b and the c are going to have very specific meanings for us. The b, well, we know what the b is going to do. It's going to alter the period of this function. So the new period can be found by taking the old period, which in this case is 2 pi, and dividing it by the b. Okay, so the b controls the period. Now, c is what we're going to call the phase shift. So the phase shift of this trig function. Now, all a phase shift is a horizontal shift of the graph. And it's not quite the same thing, or it's a different thing than a change in period for a trig function. And let's see an example of how we, first of all, go about identifying the phase shift when we've written sine or cosine in standard form. Let's do that now. Okay, so in this problem, I'm asked to identify the period and the phase shift for each function. So I have two functions here. So what we do is we write the trig functions in standard form, just like I did on the previous page. And you see how x is being multiplied by 2? That's why inside these parentheses, I'm going to factor out a 2. So I've got y is equal to, let me try that again, y is equal to sine of, okay, here's the 2 factored out. And then once you factor that out, what do you have? Well, it's going to be an x. You see, I'm mentally distributing, right? So x plus, well, it's got to be a 3 halves here. And it's 3 halves because 2 times 3 halves will get me back to 3. So for this function, I can see that the period is equal to 2 pi divided by 2. So the period is just pi. And what would the phase shift be? Now this one's kind of tricky. The phase shift is always x minus something. So the only way you're going to get x plus 3 halves is if we took x and we subtracted what? Well, negative 3 halves. So x minus negative 3 halves gives x plus 3 halves. And that's why the phase shift, it's not positive in this case. It's equal to negative 3 halves. And it's going to be important, the sign of the phase shift is going to be important in a moment, as we're going to see. So just remember that the phase shift is always x minus c, and the c is the phase shift, but you have to write it as subtraction to be able to identify it. Okay, and for this next function, once again, I'm going to write this in standard form. So I've got y is equal to, okay, it's going to be cosine of, okay, the 1/4 gets factored out, and then I have x minus something. Now, x minus what? Well, it's got to be 20. And the reason it's 20, of course, is because 1/4 times 20 gives positive 5. And I can see for this function, the period is equal to, well, 2 pi divided by 1/4. And that's equal to 8 pi. And the phase shift, let's see, that would be, it's already got a, you know, it's already in the form x minus something, and that something is 20. So notice that the phase shift does not have to contain it doesn't have to be a multiple of pi. Over here, it was negative 3 halves. I guess there was no pi here as well, and no pi here, right? This is just 20. In the previous example, or in future examples, I should say, sometimes the phase shift ends up having a multiple of pi in it. It doesn't have to, though. Okay, now that we know how to find the phase shift, what is the meaning of it? Let's go ahead and see a graph that'll illustrate that. Okay, so I have two graphs here. And this graph over here on the top left is the graph of cosine. And this is just plain old cosine. I haven't scaled the axes because I just wanted you to concentrate on the form. Now notice that this graph and the graph below it, these two functions have the same period. In other words, you have to go the same distance on the x-axis, if you will, to complete a cycle, right? You still have to go that same distance here. But the value at zero, that is the starting point, if you will, of cosine has changed. No longer does it start at zero, right? It starts over here. That distance that I had to go to the right to get the starting point of the cycle, that is the meaning of the geometric interpretation of the phase shift. So the phase shift, whatever number you get for the phase shift, in this case, it tells you where the starting point is to the right. Now, do you see how this function started to the right of this function? That's because the phase shift is greater than zero. So when you have a positive phase shift, that starts you to the right of where you would have started had you not had that phase shift. And over for this function, well, this is the basic graph of sine, and I can see sine usually starts right here. And what happened now? Well, now this curve, the sine function started a little bit to the left. And once again, the phase shift would be the number that gives you how much the graph has been shifted to the left. So the phase shift over here would be, what kind of number do you think? Positive or negative? It would be a negative number. It would be less than zero. And the reason is because you have a horizontal shift of the original function, but now to the left, okay? So when the phase shift is positive, you take your original trig function and just shift it to the right. And when the phase shift is negative, you take your original trig function and simply shift it to the left. So the phase shift truly is a horizontal shift of the graph. It doesn't change the period though, right? In both these cases, you know, this curve compared to that curve, and that curve compared to this curve, the period didn't change. The period affects, you know, either a compression or a stretch of the graph in the horizontal direction. That didn't happen here. We simply cut and paste these graphs and either moved them to the left, or here I moved the graph to the right. Okay, so now that we know how to find the phase shift and we know how to interpret it, let's go ahead and do an example putting it all together. Okay, so in this example, we're asked to identify the period, the phase shift, and then graph the function. Okay, so what we do is we write the function in standard form, just like before. So y is equal to, it's going to be cosine of, well, factor out that 2, so 2 times x minus pi over 2. Okay, so once we've done that, we can get the period, right? So the period, well, that's equal to 2 pi divided by 2, and that's equal to pi. And the phase shift, well, from what we talked about earlier, the phase shift is the number that you're subtracting, so in this case, positive pi over 2. And notice how that phase shift is positive. And what that basically means is that you're going to have cosine, but it's going to be moved pi over 2 units to the right because it's positive. Okay, once we've identified those features, we know what to expect with the graph. But what I like to do, and I encourage you to do as well, is take your argument in this form, that is the factored form, and first set it equal to where cosine used to start on the x-axis. And that would be 0, right? So first, 2 times x minus pi over 2, I'm going to set it equal to 0, and then I'm going to set the argument equal to where cosine used to end, which is 2 pi. So 2 times x minus pi over 2 is equal to 2 pi. Okay? Now that you've done that, isolate x in both equations. So we're going to divide by 2, and I get x minus pi over 2 equals 0. And so for this one, it's going to be x equals positive pi over 2. And then for the next one, divide by 2, and I get x minus pi over 2 is equal to pi. Now, I'm going to add pi over 2 to both sides, and I get this, x equals pi over 2 plus pi. Now, usually we add these together, and I'll do that in a moment, but I want to stop here with you and illustrate something. Do you see what's happened? This is the new starting point. It starts at pi over 2, and this is the new ending point, pi over 2 plus pi. Notice how the starting point is no longer x equals 0. It's x equals pi over 2, and that's exactly what we expected from the phase shift. The phase shift gives the new starting point for sine or cosine. And it turns out it's a little more complicated for some of the other functions, but for sine and cosine, which are by far the most important of the trig functions, the phase shift gives you the new starting point. So we're starting at pi over 2, and where are we ending? Well, pi over 2 plus pi. Now what does that mean? That means we had to go pi to complete the cycle. So you can see that the period is this, right? It's the pi here, which is what we expected. And I know that because, look, it's my starting point and my starting point plus pi. And so I had to go that far to complete the cycle, right? Pi units to complete the cycle. Okay, now that we've figured out our starting and ending points, what I like to do is take the ending point, which is pi over 2 plus pi, and then subtract off the starting point, which is pi over 2. I take that whatever I get when I subtract that off, and I divide by 4, and that gives me what I call my step size. So my step size. And what is it equal to? Well, the pi over 2's cancel, right? And I get just pi over 4. Now what that means is I start at pi over 2, and I step in pi over 4. And I do that all the way until I get to pi over 2 plus pi, okay? So let's go ahead and plot the function now that we know what to expect and we have an idea of how to plot points. So we start at pi over 2, right? So at pi over 2, I get 1, which is right here. So the first peak of cosine is now to the right. It's no longer at 0, right? That's the effect of the phase shift. Okay, then I step in pi over 4, and I get 0. Step in another pi over 4, and I get negative 1, right? Because I'm thinking about the basic points, or the basic, the five significant points for cosine. Step in another pi over 4, I'm back at 0. And then another pi over 4 brings me to my ending point, which is this, right? When I add those together, I get 3 pi over 2, which is what I'm seeing here. I end at 3 pi over 2. And we know the basic graph of cosine, right? It looks like that wave. So let's go ahead and draw that in now. And there it is, right? It's just the basic graph of cosine, but it's been shifted. So this right here, that is positive pi over 2, that's your phase shift. And from the starting point all the way until the end, right, how far you have to go, that of course is your period. Okay, so that's how you graph a trig function with a period change and a phase shift, which is by far the most important examples when you're doing like physics or engineering problems, or math problems, of course. Okay, until next time.